Honestly, being with parents has been great, but fundamentally, this is like where my heart and soul is. Yeah. So.
29-year-old Joe recently returned from 5 months abroad, and a lack of funds meant moving back in with mum and dad.
So I kind of view it as short-term pain for long-term gain.
A journalist, she then got her old job back at a lesbian magazine.
Welcome back aboard.
Woo! Good to be back.
And whilst away, she also picked up a girlfriend. Alicia and Joe met in LA.
I think she's beautiful, which I think is a good start, but on a slightly deeper level, she understands me and I have so much respect and admiration for her.
I love her spontaneity and her passion for life. I honestly cannot predict the next 5 minutes with her.
Although Jo has a beautiful blonde to run to, life with mum and dad is affecting both her street cred and her patience.
I just think that me and my parents are quite different fundamentally. I'm quite liberal. I'm very liberal.
I bet they're incredibly happy to have you back though, yeah? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, from a sexuality perspective, my parents have been great. And any confusion has been around just not understanding how it all works. And I was confused when I came out. I didn't know what the hell I was letting myself in for, but I knew that I couldn't keep on dating guys because it just felt all wrong.
She's relatively supportive though, yeah?
Yeah, she's supportive.
Yeah. You know when I met her at the train?
Yeah.
She didn't think I was gay.
She said that.
Well, she said, you know, I'm fine with my daughter, but you're not gay, are you?
Brilliant.
Yeah.
That's brilliant.
So, how do I answer this one?
Well, actually, me and your daughter, I am feeling a bit frustrated, but it does feel a little bit like a step back. But obviously, I know that it's temporary, and I'm kind of pleased that I've got my parents there to support me. But I just feel really isolated from my mates. It's not where I see myself in the future, and I'm looking just to get myself central. Well, East London as soon as possible, really.
Jo might be desperate to fly the nest, but she's always up for a bit of horseplay.
Oh, my God, a pony!
I love it. You have to ride it.
Woo!
No.
Ride it.
No, ride it back and forth.
I don't know how to... Oh, like this.
You're so sporty.
Thank you, boy.
Oh, my God, it's so cute.
In Soho, former Big Brother contestant Shabby and best mate Cheryl are working on their latest money-making scheme, turning Shabby into a TV presenter.
I don't even have anyone to hold the mic.
You worry me.
We're in Soho. We've got no plan, but we do have a script. Can you hurry up?
I'm just fiddling with it.
Bonkers.
Shabby is a jack of all trades and so far, master of none. In fact, she changes jobs like most people change their underwear.
I've been a photographer, a journalist, a criminologist, an anthropologist, a nanny, a musician, an actor, a producer, a prose writer, a poetry writer, a spoken word artist.
So the latest idea is for Shabby to present a series all about bohemianism. Sounds like TV gold, with a script scribbled on the tube.
Me?
But being a presenter isn't as easy as you might think.
Nova.
I'm going to get stuck into a lifestyle of art, pop. That's difficult to do. To the blockbuster smash. What's it called? Moulin Rouge? Fuck off.
You know that.
So... That's nice, isn't it?
They're all going to start coming this way and singing and dancing. Not quite like that, though.
I want to find out what the fuck is going on. And follow me on the road to Bohemia.
Good. I like it.
But it's not a wrap just yet, because our budding filmmakers have decided they want Shabby to up the ante.
And get really bohemian, man.
Decadent enough?
I think that's decadent enough.
Yes!
Oh, loving it. Thank you so much.
But it seems Shabby's props for this last scene have somewhat gone to her head.
Hi. I'm a lesbian. Shit. Hi. I'm lesbian. Lesbian. I'm...
An hour and a half later, they finally wrapped. And it's time to review a hard day's work.
You look decadent.
They are going to think we're taking the piss.
Well, we are a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, but the whole point was that it's supposed to be you weren't quite sure if I was taking the piss or wasn't taking the piss. It's now quite blatantly obvious that I am taking the piss. I'm talking bollocks, looking really hideous. A TV exec is going to look at that and go, love the concept. Who the fuck is that? I actually can't deal with anymore. Why didn't you tell me?
Tell you what?
My hair looks like dog shit.
It doesn't look like dog shit.
Underneath all the front, Shabby's actually her own worst critic.
I think maybe this is why I move projects so quickly before anybody finds out what a talentless hack I am.
Before they discover that you're a fraud.
Before they discover I'm a fraud, exactly. Yeah. And I'm actually not very good at anything I do. And the problem is, because I'm such a cocky shit, or I pretend to be, no, you know, most people don't know I feel like that. So people think I'm an arrogant wanker on this hand, but then I beat myself up about basically everything I do.
I don't think there's much you could do about it. You're just a fragile artist.
Coming up, there's an unusual appetizer at dinner.
If I want a penis, I have a strap on.
And candy bar's Sam gets her knickers in a twist.
I need someone who can melt chocolate and not fuck it up. No, it's not just put it in the microwave.
After 6 weeks of living with mum and dad, 29-year-old Jo Webber has finally got her independence. A mate in East London's gone on holiday and asked Jo to flat sit. To mark the occasion, and so mum can see where she'll be living, Jo's hosting a Friday night dinner, an important feature of the Jewish week.
What's that?
Chicken.
Right.
It's a big chicken.
It is a big chicken.
I bought a very big chicken.
Oh, you are the best Jewish mother in all of London.
Ha, ha, ha. Is Alicia coming?
Alicia's coming, of course. OK, mum, just to let you know that there's no shoes in the house.
I'll take my boots off, it's not a problem. This place is so nice. It really is.
As kind of Jewish people, you know, we like to eat, and it's going to be good just to kind of light the candles, cut the bread, the challah, which is delicious, my favourite bread in the world, and just have like a proper kind of roast chicken and veg and just show a little bit more about Jewish culture.
Now, in there, there's roast potatoes and roast sweet potatoes.
Right.
Presumably, you've got all the knives and cutlery and crockery and all that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There's four knives.
Obviously not, then.
Oh, dear.
I'm a bit stressed out about that, Mum. What are we going to do?
Aren't you going to be cold dressed like that?
No, I'm not remotely cold, and there's a reason why I'm dressing like this. OK.
Jo doesn't even seem to be able to work the oven.
Right, how's...
Do you know how to turn it on?
No.
Oh, dear.
Do not know how this works.
I need to get my glasses on, then I'll be able to help you. It's so greasy.
Mum, but let's not insult the oven. Yes. Go. Shall we high five
that? 1 hour and 15 minutes. Come on, give me a hand up.
Oh, lovely. Yeah, I'm so excited.
Tonight's crowd are a cosmopolitan bunch.
Hi, guys, come in.
There's Joe's American girlfriend, Alicia. And her Italian friend, Andrea.
Hi, guys.
Soon followed by Israeli, Avavit.
You look like you've met me, but I was dressed as a man.
Oh, that's right. Oh, I remember you yesterday then.
Do you met? So this is my girlfriend, Alicia.
Hi, how are you?
It is my first Friday dinner, is what they call it. So I don't know much about it. I mean, Joe's said she's going to run me through the whole concept tonight as we have dinner, so I'm excited.
With Joe's mum the only non-lesbian in the room, conversation soon turns to what it's like to be gay in other countries.
How does it go in Italy?
Yeah, how does it work in Italy?
If you are a woman, I think the advice that mothers give to their daughter is, well, if you're a woman, you can fake. You don't have to be gay, really. We've been doing it for years.
That is ridiculous.
Sometimes it's
to me, something like that is ridiculous.
The final ingredient is a dash more heterosexuality. Joe's cousin Lee and his Mexican girlfriend Veronica arrive, and the Friday night ritual can fully begin.
And we say, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam. And you just take one piece.
It's the first time Veronica has met Joe's friends.
You don't need to worry, Veronica. All these ladies are gay, so it's not...
So exactly.
All of them.
You see the way I got my hair?
You?
Classic.
Gay?
else you
yes,
can
I am.
You're just thinking in a woman who is ugly and like unattractive, you know? And it's like, oh yeah, they are lesbians because they cannot get any men.
Yeah, I had plenty of people coming to me and say, oh, do you know that this is a gay club?
I had the same thing myself.
Because I was.
You look too straight.
I look straight.
But like two women,
just put it
what do they do?
Because she just seems this is the kind of question that we get all the time in pubs. We just love each other. Like, you love him, I love my girlfriend.
But
it's fine. You guys go to the.
I need something. Pretty.
Sorry, I'm getting confused.
You don't have to have a penis, really, to make love. You don't have to have a penis to have an orgasm. And plus, thank God that we got sex sharply. If I want a penis, I have a strap on. A gay man who doesn't know that she's gay. He doesn't know who's gay. The love that we share.
You mentioned kids. Is that something you think about?
Kids. Oh, I'm gonna have a kid.
You're gonna have a kid?
Yes,
a baby.
Yes, I'll proudly say that. Yes. Me and my partner, we have a baby.
How's that gonna work?
Like, you still can go with some guy and like, oh, he's cute, I'm gonna have a baby from him.
Well, one night stand, baby.
No, it's not gonna be a now stand. No.
Could you have sex with a man?
Do I have a child? No, God, no. I was saying to her, if she couldn't have a child, would you lie the fact that she would go with another man and have a child?
I would not like that.
Let us have the
record.
Do you think that amongst lesbians, women are less likely to want to have children? I mean, you obviously want to be a mother very much.
No, I don't want to be a mother at all.
Nick, I'm sure your mum is very happy about it.
Looks like there's no pitter-patter of tiny Webbers on the cards.
So how did you guys enjoy dinner?
So much.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Wasn't it great?
I really enjoyed it.
Thank you, Mum. Thank you, Mum.
Yes, yeah. I did cook.
I love
it.
After their shoot last week, Shabby and best mate Cheryl are in Brighton to persuade a TV company they're the next big thing.
Who do we think we are?
I have no idea who we think we are.
We haven't even worked out an opening gambit.
They've managed to get a meeting at Lambent Productions, who make programmes for all the major channels.
So professionals do this usually.
Yeah, we are not that. We'll make it up as we go along.
I can tell I'm nervous because I start to get a bit gassy.
That's going to help.
So will TV executive Jessica Lee buy their idea about bohemianism?
Take a seat.
Thank you very much.
Right, so tell me what this is, the taster you've produced.
At its heart, it is quite a serious documentary series, I guess. It is generally educational, but it's really fun as well. It's a show called On the Road to Bohemia. Would you like to see the teaser trailer? I really am coming to stand over your shoulder.
Right, some evidence.
And murmur in your ear.
Can I have a little bit closer,
please?
Yep. The shoot was a bit, well, shabby. Yeah. So is their effort good enough to impress?
On the Road to Bohemia.
Oh, I like your font.
We're going to get stuck into a lifestyle of art, poverty, sex and debauchery, all of which, of course,
I want to find out what goes on in a world where Franz Kafka and Sienna Miller can never be referenced in the same context.
Good point. That's very good. I really like the fact that you've gone to so much trouble with your taste, and also this is incredibly well presented.
Oh, thank you. And I'm worried about it.
I think the first pitching, I think you've done a really brilliant job.
Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah. Thank you. You're a very nice lady.
See you.
Yes.
Bye. Thank you so much.
Take care. I'm quite pleased with how it went. Obviously, I can't gauge exactly what the fuck just happened.
With this particular idea, I certainly don't see it as a six-part series. I think that's really ambitious. It's been 5 minutes. What's the problem? She fucking hated it, didn't she?
Oh, my God, she hates us. She thinks we're crap. Oh, I'm going to have a crisis of confidence.
In East London, journalist Jo Webber is on the prowl for an unusual scoop. Looking for more freelance work, she's planning on writing up the latest sex toys on the market.
So I'm on my way to Shush, just to kind of see some friends, check out what's new in the market. I've always had a bit of an interest in, I guess, you know, sex toys and kind of the industry. I used to write a column. I was a sexpert. Yeah, big fan.